In this video, we are using Archimedes' method to find an approximation for the number pi. He did that by simply using Pythagoras' theorem to approximate the circumference of a circle using the perimeter of a polygon. Remember Pythagoras' theorem? To find any missing side in a right-angled triangle, we need the other two sides. For example, in this triangle, the hypotenuse is 1 and one of the legs is 0.5. To find the other leg, we substitute the values and find b by taking the square root. Let's see how to approximate pi. The circumference of a circle with radius 1 is equal to 2 pi. Archimedes used a regular hexagon inscribed in that circle because he knew that this is made of 6 equilateral triangles. In other words, that side, AB, equals the radius, 1, so the perimeter is 6. Since the hexagon is inscribed inside the circle, the perimeter is smaller than the circumference. 2 pi must be bigger than 6, so pi must be bigger than 3. Archimedes realized that by dividing the circle in regular polygons with more sides, he could get a better approximation, and so he did. Drawing a 12-sided regular polygon inside the circle and multiplying the length of each new side by 12 will give us a better approximation for the circumference. The first step is to halve the previous side, AB. The length is 0.5. We can now use Pythagoras, since the angle is 90 degrees. The side joining the center and the midpoint is the square root of the difference of the square of the hypotenuse, 1, and the previous length, 0.5. Since OC equals the radius 1, the length joining C and the midpoint is 1 take away 0.866. Using this result and the length, 0.5, we can use Pythagoras again to figure out the hypotenuse AC. The length is 0.518. Since the 12-sided polygon is inscribed inside the circle, 2 pi must be bigger than 12 AC, so pi must be bigger than 6 AC. Replacing AC with 0.518, pi must be bigger than 3.108. Let's carry on. Again, we have the previous side AC, which results in 0.259. We can now use Pythagoras twice. OM is the square root of the difference of 1 square and 0.259 square. We subtract this from 1 because OD is the radius of our polygon, and this is still 1. The length DM is 0.034. We use Pythagoras again to figure out the hypotenuse AD. The length of each side of this polygon is 0.261. Since this is a 24-sided polygon, 2 pi must be bigger than 24 AD. So pi must be bigger than 12 AD. Replacing AD with 0.261, we know that pi must be bigger than 3.132. Archimedes carried on with a 48-sided polygon. He halved the previous side, AD. He used Pythagoras on the right triangle to calculate the distance between the center 0 and the new midpoint. Then the length joining E and the new midpoint is 1 take away 0.9914. The length of each side is 0.1307. Pi is bigger than 3.1368. Archimedes even used a 96-sided polygon. He figured out that the hypotenuse AF must be 0.0654. Pi must be bigger than 3.1392. Archimedes' method returns approximations for pi that converge to the actual value of the number pi. Very clever if we take into account the simplicity of the maths behind. If you enjoyed this video, subscribe to this channel and hit the notification bell to receive updates.